man. But I give Matt easy. Half the shit. I'm just complaining about dumb stuff too. So don't worry about it. I complain about everything. I haven't played this game in a long fucking time. I saw there's new scenarios put on. Dude, I die a lot. I can't ever finish. I can't even fucking get these anyways. The new ones. You gotta order them. This one looks like it could be fun. One of the games, like, just sat here and cussed at for a good fucking minute, where I was just sitting here just fucking cussing, like, for an hour just straight.
We roam the still, cold world, no horizon in sight. The rulers of old, stripped pride and glory. It feels as yesterday we were turning the wheels of progress. Until the frost stopped it all. Suddenly, without a warning. When tides had changed, they changed for all of us, no matter wealth or class. We've lost our world to snow. And with it, our last traces of humanity.
That's fucked up. It's like the next Ice Age.
We bid farewell to plenty. For those who remained, came the time to adapt. We decided to leave our homes and head north. We roamed for weeks, maybe months, leaving behind all the things we once believed had made us. It was hope that pushed us forward. Slowly, step by step. We knew the cost of our journey. And we paid the price. 100 times. Finally, the time has come to build the last city on Earth.
A new home. I got gum in my mouth. I should probably not chew gum. Try to speak at the same time. A new home. We fled from London and crossed the sea to reach the frozen north. On the way, our convoy was hit by a blizzard and scattered. A handful of us managed to reach the site this generator, only to find it frozen solid, abandoned. Why is no one here? Did any of our people survive the blizzard? Are there any others out there? Whatever we do, we should expect the worst now that the world as we know it has crumbled. We have to survive. So it's just like in London or like the whole entire world? Fight the cold, we need the generator working. It provides heat and power to other buildings. Without it, we'll freeze to death. Stockpile some coal and start the generator. Yeah, man, I was about to just die on that last game, so I just stopped playing. Freaking gnats in my fucking... Yeah, that's it. Oh man. I can't believe I played this game for so fucking long. I literally just fucking sat here and stared at these little... my little minions, as I might say. Five of them there. What the fuck are they? I forgot, it's just the animations. As soon as you put them there, they're already working.
Good job.
construction. Use left trigger to open the command hub. Access construction menu by selecting it on the radial or pressing A. Build a cookhouse and start preparing meals. Housing problem. No roof over our heads. Captain, people are understandably concerned about the lack of shelter. They're falling ill from sleeping outside in this terrible cold. We'd better do something about it. You'll have 2 days to provide shelter for 40 people. I'll provide shelter for everyone. I won't address this right now. I'll provide shelter for everyone. from our convoy, with basic resources secured for now. We can try to rescue the people we left behind, build a beacon, scout Frostland, and save as many survivors. Survivors from our expedition as possible. You'll need a workshop to design plans for more advanced buildings. The wisdom of the crowd. Captain, when facing demands, remember this. People usually look for the quickest solution, not the best one. You don't have to agree to everything they ask for. If you fix the problems your way, it's fine. People from our convoy. Build a workshop. Build the beacon. Rescue survivors at our lost expedition. Rescue survivors. Damn it, dude. I can't spell survivors. I mean, spell. I can't say survivors. Survivors. Rescue survivors of our lost expedition. Provide shelter for everyone. 10 out of 80. I'll get it. Some of your people fell ill due to the cold in their workplace and homes. To treat them, build medical posts, or other more advanced buildings left unchecked. Sicknesses will be your undoing. To get raw food, build a hunter's hut or a hothouse using the construction menu. Food is processed in the cookhouse into more efficient food rations. If you don't supply people with food, they will revolt or starve. Critical shortage. The number of sick is rising and we don't have enough materials to build a medical post. Perhaps a short burst of effort could help us gather the necessary resources. Consider signing the emergency shift law. Open the book of laws. Emergency shift. Sometimes we have to concentrate on the task at hand. At the cost of everything else or die. New ability, you can force workers in any facility to work for the next 24 hours. Fighting arena. Child labor, safe jobs for children. Or safe jobs, child shelter. Emergency shift.
Hear me, hear me. New law in the city.
Building abilities. Press right trigger hovering over the building to open the shortcut menu. And access building abilities quickly.
Like what works for you today, like everybody else. Look up and do it.
Rather fucking die? Quite literally? Literally? Quite literally? Quite literally? Work time. these guys have better fucking work hours than I do. Heat. People having shelter will cure some of the being sick. Hell yeah. Only 10 people don't have shelter. But because now there's a wall of shelter, they can just fucking huddle up as close as they want to this thing. Dude. Oh man. I'd be fucking sleeping up here, right there. That's where I would be fucking sleeping. Throw a tent. A little tiny tent from like here to here. Cover that part out. To here, so that way they could still go up there and work on it. I'd just sleep right there, like a little cat. Yeah, 1700 is what, 5 o'clock? 1730 is 5:30. Right now it's 0200. They get off at they start at 0800 and they get off at 1500. Come on, dude. That's some pretty fucking awesome work hours right there. But these guys work fucking 7 days a week. Well, I mean, these guys are gonna work every fucking day until they die. So, yeah. I feel like the hunters have it the best. Because they just go out here and hunt like rabbits and stuff. It's pretty cool. I feel like these guys have the fucking, like, work in the cookhouse. Like, dude, you are like the most luckiest piece of shit in the world. Like, there's no way you're not eating some kind of scraps while you're cooking. Dude, I swear to God, this is how real life feels like. fucking close my eyes. What is this? Resource shortage. We're getting short on resources. Our needs are great and growing by the hour. To address this, we can enact a law that... To address this, we can enact a law that will allow us to extend working hours. We already did this. Extend shifts? Oh, shit. Building a city in this frozen hell requires sacrifice. People will get more done if they work longer shifts. Jesus Christ, dude. Your shift length. You can extend the workday in any facility to 14 hours. God damn. I've worked 16-hour shifts IRL before, though. But not every day. It was like two 16-hour shifts. And then third day you got off, and then like a whole 24 hours you got off, and then come back, do another two 16-hour shifts, and then you get your weekend. Come back, do two 16-hour shifts, get a day off, to do two 16-hour shifts. Get your weekend, then come back. Your weekend's only 2 days, so. Or you could work a whole week straight and get a whole week off, which that's pretty fucking cool too. That's like 24 hours.
A new law has passed.
What? 10 hours isn't enough? I suppose in our circumstances. My father used to tell us we're lucky to work 10 hours a day. These guys are just not doing anything right now. Go get some fucking wood.
Work time. Get back to work.
Or, I mean, coal. Thank you. Oh, we're out of wood. I fucking read that as food. Buildings have to be connected by connected to roads to function. Build them in the construction menu. Shelter promise fulfilled. Everyone feels relieved with a roof, even a flapping one over their heads. Hope rises. Workforce. largest temperature changes affect the whole city. Pay close attention to the weather forecast is in the upper right-hand corner. The city info panel, accessible through the command hub, provides more details. Plan accordingly, lest your people freeze to death. Sir, a woman came forward after we built the workshop. She said that her husband and daughter didn't reach the city with the main group, but she's sure they're still out there. She wants to join the first scout team we'll send out. She urges you to hurry. We'll do what we can. Halfway hope. Hell yeah, man. Yeah, the workshop is always hot for some reason, which is good. So you could put it in front of stuff. You can introduce a new law. Adaptation, find ways to battle hunger, sickness, and apathy. Soup, food additives. Radical treatment to sustain life. Cemetery corpse disposal. Child labor, safe jobs for child's shelter. Child labor, all laws. Medical apprentices, engineer apprentices. Children will be safer if they stay in child shelters during the day, and they won't cause any mischief. New building, child shelter. Hope will rise. Providing all children with a place in a child shelter. gives a permanent hope bonus. Negative, you will have to build a child shelter. Child labor, safe jobs. There aren't enough hands to do all the work. We'll allow children to be employed in safe workplaces like cookhouse or hothouse. Children can work in safe workplaces. Hope will fall slightly. Child workers can be injured in an accident.
Listen, everyone. New law is signed.
Kids could do something useful during their time in the shelter. And what if they don't? What if they go going to do all day? Watch something, something? Either way, they're gonna end up working. Might as well put them in the medical area and then end in the workshop. Days and 21 hours, build a child shelter.
Excuse me.
I don't know, every time I play this game, it makes me think about the future. Like, dude, this kind of shit could fucking happen. Maybe not the next Ice Age, but the next flood? Maybe. Maybe not to the extent of what the last one was, because... I don't know, man. You're asking the wrong fucking guy. I didn't even think I was gonna be alive this long. But here I am. We're doing fine, all things considered. Got 31 food. I kind of want to start making soup and shit. Discontent. 5 points every time they have to go to work. I hope I don't freeze to death on duty. It's getting colder with each day. Depleted. Oh shit. We need coal anyways.
Thank you.
every time I play this game, I feel like a god. This could be us. This is what God feels like. Is this what God feels like? People has become gravely ill due to frostbite. This will keep happening if people have to keep working in such cold conditions. Consider signing the radical treatment or sustain of life law. We must do something. Oh, finished. Fucking the hell. I did build a fucking... understand why he wasn't fucking going to the fucking... I can't remember how to send people here. There's no patience. Why the fuck aren't there any patience? Why the fuck did I build this if people weren't gonna go there? Physically click on them? Dude, I could have swore I could fucking send the person there. Dude, what the fuck, dude? I could have swore I was able to send them directly to there. Like, why the fuck is nobody going to the fucking hospital? Dude, there's still nobody in here. Did I not build a fucking road to it? No way in hell I did. Build a medical post and nobody goes to it. Why? What the fuck is going on? Yeah, man, this game pisses me off, dude. Just something about it just fucking makes me so angry. I hadn't gotten water in a while, so I was like, fucking, oh, I was dying of thirst for a good fucking minute, man. Finally went out, got some fucking water. It's pretty fucking awesome. I just forget how awesome water is. Just get sick. Dude, I swear to God, that's how it feels like in real life. Like, I'm just like little Sims fucking waking up, trying to wake up in the morning, dude. I swear, dude. Like, I'll be laying there and I'll be like, alright, 5 more minutes. Look back at the clock. Whole hour went by. I'm like, what the flying fuck? I'm like, alright, I'm gonna fucking sit up. Sit up. I'm like, look back at the clock. 30 minutes went by. I'm like, dude, how the fuck did that happen? And it's like, dude, somebody, it's like, I'm in a simulation. Somebody just has the fucking, whatever this button is called. The speed up button. The slow down button. They just have it on max all the time. They're just like, oh no, he got it. About to throw a lasagna inside of the fucking oven. Looks pretty good. Nope. some coal. Oh, I got to do this. Oh no, I didn't. I did do it. Yes. Have to. Fucking have to. Need that. Oh, right now. Just gonna run out of food. You guys can starve for a little bit, and we'll be okay. That's how I feel my fucking... my life is right now. The guy controlling my Sims game just fucking with me. Some of you guys are sick. Y'all need to be fucking eating soup anyways.
Listen, everyone. New law is signed.
how to fucking give you guys sawdust. That just sounds like y'all are gonna fucking get really sick. I think soup is way better than sawdust, in my opinion. Make vegetables. Tell me how much time I have left. Thank you. We have just used our first steam core. Steam cores are a necessary component in advanced technology. We can't manufacture steam cores in the city, so let's hope that our scouts find them during their expeditions. The fuck? Guess not want to eat or something? Thank you.
Thank you.
What? I thought that was fucking the other thing. Oh wait, all I have to do is undo it. I think it does it on its own when you press that. That's annoying. Why is nobody making food? Oh, that's right, they don't make food on off time. Dude, how are we losing fucking... What the fuck? Well, I only last 10 days. Damn it. I can't even fucking make it past this. Why aren't people fucking work? Everybody's sick. Oh my god. Ah, fuck this, dude. Fuck that, dude. I fucking hate this game. Fuck this shit. Fuck, man. I don't know, dude. The farthest I've gotten was 30 days. But that's after, like, playing this shit over and over again. And then I had to do some fucked up shit in the game. So I'm like, dude, what the hell? It's like, the more fuck... It's like, if you want to survive longer, you have to, like, the more radical the shit is, you have to do. Like, I'm about to die. That's why I just stopped playing this one. I got to 30 days and I was like, dude, fuck this bullshit. I just logged out. I'm playing on fucking medium too. Like, I've gotten pretty far, but it's like, god damn it, dude. It's fucking hard. I got 12 in the hospital right now. I got 3 amputees. I got 1, like, that's not in the hospital. Ugh. I don't know. I thought I was going to be able to do better. I don't know. This guy's just have been in a limbo. Since I've last played, they're just like, what do we do? Nobody's dying. Guess it's okay. That's what it was. I was running out of food. I don't know. If anybody knows anything more than me, let me know what I can do to survive longer, because fucking, I'm a little bit of a at a loss. I should probably unlock number 4. That way I can get all house insulation. I don't know, man. This game's fucking hard. Play a different game.